So here's one of the upper waste rock piles. You can see what the ore cart tracks would have been here. These are the cross ties. But this is a waste rock pile that has a really incredible view panning across here. You can see all the way across the valley. And we're pretty high up. And then right behind me is the entrance we're going to check out. That has a nice timbered portico. So let's go check it out. Okay, so here's a Y intersection or a T intersection. And you have a tunnel going off to the left that way. And then a tunnel to the right. But that is unfortunately collapsed. Look at that. Those timbers were in the overhead and they came down vertically. That's a major collapse. So this tunnel to the left, right here at the intersection, is a vertical shaft. Let's get a shot looking down here real quick. Oh, that's not a shaft, that's a stope. That is, that's square set timbering in there, basically. And there's air coming up. Let me zoom in there. That's a pretty good example of the square set timbering, which was used in large voids like stopes. They did it for support. So there's probably lower levels that can be accessed somehow, but not from up here, I don't think. And there you can see all the talc. And you can see on the talc there, all the pickaxe marks from the miners doing the digging. Okay, so we'll continue down the tunnel here. Looks like right here, Tom was saying this is an ore pass. Oh, that's what that is. Just a real small, it's almost like a winze, but yeah, it's an ore pass. There's a lot of air coming up out of there too. Let me zoom in down there. Sometimes the camera can pick up stuff that we can't see from up here. I'm trying to get my light in there. Oh, it seems quiet in here all of a sudden. Did you notice that?
Yeah.
It just seems
soft.
Yeah.
Buttery.
Oh, look at this. This is a slow motion collapse. We're catching a slow motion collapse in action. Right there. Here's an ore chute. So it must be an upper level or upper stopes. All this timbering above us.
Look at, somebody must have pulled the board out here.
Yeah, they did, yep. Not a good idea. That all could let go. And then another skull and crossbones. I guess that's a skull and crossbones. Almost looks like a cat. And that's a dead end. And then continuing this way, it looks like it's a major collapse. Yep. Another slow motion collapse in progress. And it's totally collapsed back up in there. And there's an ore chute right there. So we don't know how extensive this mine was. Probably somewhat extensive, but... And then here on my left is some miner's graffiti. This says, I think that's Mexico. I don't know. I forgot the I if it is. Might have been a Mexican miner working in here at one point. And there's a retaining wall on the other side. But yeah. And there's, on that timber, there's hash marks, like they were keeping track of the ore cart loads. There's tally marks. So looking up here into this void, you can see all the cribbing they installed. Those timbers right there, they call that cribbing. That's all used for support. And then there's a ceiling made up of wooden planks right where my light is. And there's more talc resting on that. So these are all for support. A lot of major timbering. And then we're gonna head back out this way. Okay, so there's the bottom of the ladder. We just came down about 100 feet, near vertical, kind of sketchy. And we're at the bottom of the shaft. And look at all these load counts, the miner's dots. There's like a zillion of them here. Just look over here on the right. That's how they kept track of the loads of ore. Every dot was a cartload, I guess. And then we got a split up here, an intersection, a T-intersection. And right here is a huge Union Carbide can. They put the carbide in their headlamps. And then some kind of old garbage can lid behind it. And then here's a grease bucket. Maybe it's empty. And there's the intersection. The tunnel's going off to the left and the right. So this large stope would have had square set timbering in it. You can see some of it right up there. But most of it has fallen right here in front of us, these big timbers. And those are huge timbers. And then Tom's back there checking out a tunnel that might go a little further into the mine that way. And then there's an opening. The stope continues down over there behind these timbers. So we're making our way through this stope with the collapsed square set timbering. Here's looking down on top of it. And we just came from that tunnel right there behind Julie. And look at all the cribbing on top of that for support. And this is all talc. And we're going to head down that way where Tom is. There's a branching tunnel here to the left. Is that the bridge you were talking about?
Yeah, and then take a look up here while you're here, Frank.
Oh, yeah, that's what we were looking at. I think you're right. More square set timbering with a workers' platform up there. See that platform right where my light is? Really rare to see this square set timbering. It's not very common. Usually collapses. And then there's some kind of a winze here going down. I don't want to fall down in that hole.
That goes around the corner and dead ends at a chute, a wooden chute.
Okay, yeah, Tom said it goes around the corner. There's a chute and dead end, so I'm not going to cross that.
This is where I was thinking that.
Big collapse here. Look at that top boulder. So we just came from that way, and we're headed down these ladders over here. Tom's already making the initial descent, and then we have a sign here. Dangerous. That's what that says. And we're gonna head down these ladders to the lower levels. Okay, so we're coming down this ladder system. I just came down the first ladder. You see it there, right up there. Julie's making her way down. She's way up there. About a 100-foot ladder, something like that, maybe more. And then a little ladder right here. That's in really good condition. Look at that. It looks almost brand new. And then we're going to continue. Here's a more gradually inclined ladder, and that continues down. You can see Tom way down there, and that's where we're headed. So here's the bottom of the ladder system. We came down probably, 100, 200 feet total. But anyway, we're at the level here, and the tunnel going that way, and a lot of timbering. Look at all that timbering. It's classic mine timbering with ore cart tracks going that way. And some explosive boxes right there. Atlas Powder Company. It's upside down, but Tom's coming down off the ladder. There he is.
We did it.
So here at this station down the mine is an old Trojan's explosives box. And we'll continue down this timbered tunnel. Okay, so Julie's making her way down. We are really deep in this mine. This is probably, what, 150 feet, this section, 200, something like that.
I'm going to hit the junction train.
Okay, so this tunnel's blocked off with danger, keep out. But we're going to go check it out. There's a chute down there on the left. So here's a winch for this inclined shaft, and Tom's going to start making his descent. And here, we're all going to go down there, and then here's the control.